By the end of this video, you will master these three pleated tools, such as the pleat tool, the pleat fold tool, and the pleat sewing tool in CLO 3D. We will also be creating multiple fabrics to making the pleated patterns, then improving the pleated quality and ready to make amazing garments just like these. An evening dress, backless with front pleated, a back pleated skirt with yoke, and more. Are you ready? Let's do it. Last but also important, okay? Back to a pleat tool here. So we have this three tools right here, and that's so amazing. You can create any pleats. We can create accordion pleats. Let me go back to the garment that I showed you earlier. So the night pleats, the back pleats, the accordion pleats, it's so cool. So let me come back here, and I'm going to show you how to use the pleats tool for these pattern pieces. As you can see, we have these pleated pattern is equal to the first pattern that we have. I'm going to show you how to use the pleat tool to create the pleats for this pattern, okay? To do so, I'm going to come over here to this 2D toolbar, click on it, and see this pleat tool right here? Click on that pleat tool. Then I'm going to click one right here. Then I'm going to press down shift because I want this straight line down. Then I'm going to click one to end. Then, as you can see, this highlighted blue area, I'm going to click one to bring this pleat window. Then I'm going to select back pleat. You can select any pleats you would like, but for this example, I'm going to select back pleat. And number of pleat, I'm going to select 3. Then the depth, I'm going to select 3. After that, leave everything as is and click on OK. After that, I'm going to press down the spacebar on the keyboard to simulate. Okay, so let me zoom in just a little bit. So a pleat doesn't come out too well, but that's okay. So I'm going to come over here to this transform pattern tool, click on it to select. Then I'm going to come over here and I'm going to select on that pattern, that pleated pattern, and I'm going to right click and I want to select reset 2D arrangement selected, okay? Then I'm going to just zoom out a little bit and I want to bring that pleat up a little bit. Now I'm going to press on the spacebar one again to simulate. Okay, so this is much better. So let me zoom in a little bit and I'm going to press down the spacebar one again to stop the simulation. And by default, a pattern piece is selected. I'm going to just click one on the plate to deselect. Okay, so we finished sewing all these pleats together, guys. We finished all the hard works. Now all we need to do is improve these pleats, okay? To improve these pleats are easy, guys. First of all, the particle distance are too big because by default, I set it to 20. So I'm going to come over here and I'm going to click on to the right side right here, click on this object browser to open the object browser. And I have to click one more time on this property editor to open that as well. Okay, so as you can see, a property editor is empty. That because we do not select any pattern pieces over here, so it doesn't know that we have any property at all. So if I click on the pattern pieces now, as you can see, the property editor show us what we have. First thing, particle distance is 20. We want to change all these particle distance to 5 because 5, that's a number I came up with. You can change to you know, 7, whatever it is. But for now, I'm going to change it to 5. It's perfect. So I'm going to apply the particle distance to all these fabric pieces. To do that, I'm going to just Command or Control plus letter A to select all these pattern pieces. And I'm going to come over here to this property editor and just click and highlight it. And I'm going to type in number 5. And I'm going to press and return enter on the keyboard to confirm. Okay, so now I'm going to click 1 on the workspace to deselect, and I'm going to press on the spacebar to simulate. Ta-da! It looks better already, guy. Next, I'm going to add the fabric onto this pleated fabric. Let me zoom in just a little bit. And I'm going to press on the spacebar one again to stop the simulation. I also want to unstrengthen this pattern piece first. Again, Command or Control plus letter A, then right click and select unstrengthen. Then I'm going to press down the spacebar one again to simulate and press it one again to stop. Okay, so let's change the fabric. I'm going to change to wool fabric. To do that, I'm going to come over here to this library tab, click on it to open, then fabric, and I'm going to type in right here wool. Wool fabric is perfect for any pleated, any design that kind of give it a little bit of heavy butt. So let me select that wool cashmere, click on, and then drag and drop onto the fabric. And now a fabric, just change it to wool. Now I'm going to change the color. Just click on the fabric and I'm going to change the color to maybe a little. Okay, we have an issue here. All right, so as you can see, when I try to change the color on the fabric, it doesn't work. That's okay. To make the color see through, we have to come over here to this property editor and remove this texture, okay? So just hover the mouse to the right and you see the delete basket right there, or icon, excuse me. Click on it to delete. Now the color came through. We just change a color to kind of olive like. Let me go back in a little bit, and I want to kind of use this, you see this plus sign, just drag around. So this is another part that we can enhance a garment, how a garment look. You see how the pleat appear better if we go up a little bit or go to the right. See right there, if you come down so dark, we barely can see a pleat. But if you just increase or decrease the value of the color of the shoe, now we get to see a pleat better. It's all about realistic look, realistic feel. So in this case, right now, it looks much better already. So I'm going to click on OK to confirm. Okay, let me zoom in a little more. Wow. A pleat looks amazing, guys. Another point that I want to point out here. See up here, if you click on this icon right here to turn it off, a pleat look really flat. That's what we don't want. We want to turn that on. Now, a pleat looks really have this depth. As you can see right there, it's a huge difference. Okay. Next, I'm going to add the thickness onto this fabric, okay? I'm going to just click one on the page to deselect it. Now I'm going to just marquee select all the pattern pieces. Then you see right here under this property editor, come down to add thickness rendering. I'm going to change it. I try 1.5 is a perfect number for me, but you can just do 1, that would be fine too. Press on return enter on the keyboard to confirm. So it gave a pleat a more a little like crisp and sharpie looking. I'm going to press on the spacebar to simulate once again. And I'm going to press on the spacebar to stop the simulation. I'm going to click one on the pleat to deselect. So as you can see, now a pleat looks much better. However, there is something that we can improve on. Okay, so as you can see here, let me come to the top piece right here so we can see the effects, okay? You see right here, kind of push out, it's not even because some part of the sewing are turned, some are not. Next, I'm going to switch all the sewing to turn. So let me go in and I'm going to use the edit sewing tool over here, click on it to select. Then I'm going to zoom in right here. And I'm going to just my key select right there, okay? And if you look over here to this property editor and under sewing line type, our sewing type is custom angle rather than turn. We want to switch that to turn. To do so, I'm going to come over here to the twirling arrow, click on it, then select turn. Okay? Then press down the spacebar to simulate. Next, I'm going to press down the spacebar one again to stop the simulation and pan this 2D window to the right. I'm going to strengthen these pattern pieces. Then I'm going to press down the spacebar one again to simulate. And press down the spacebar one again to stop the simulation. And I'm going to unstrengthen. And as you can see, now a pattern piece looks much better already. Again, go to this edit sewing tool, click on it, and then my key select just that sewing, and then change it to turn. Let me double check this one. Somehow it doesn't do it. Yeah, it is turn. Perfect. I'm going to do the same right here. Switch to turn. Then come over here. Change it to turn. So now I'm going to press down the spacebar once again to simulate. Okay. And I'm going to press down the spacebar one again to stop the simulation. And I'm going to switch to transform pattern tool so we can see better. Then unfreeze this pattern piece. Click on it and then my key select, just press on shift and click on all the pattern pieces that we want to unfreeze, and then right click and select unfreeze. Next, I'm going to show you when we darken the top piece of pattern will make this pleated pattern a little more pop. To do that, I'm going to come over here, click on that fabric to select. Then I'm going to click on this copy command to copy that fabric. And I'm going to just name it small. Then I'm going to be sure to not press down the spacebar, guys, or your pleat will fall onto the floor. So I'm going to press down shift and then click, click, and click. I'm going to apply that fabric, the new one, onto the pattern pieces. Then I'm going to click on that fabric, you see right here under this object browser, and come down to color and click on it. Then I want to kind of bring the color down just a little bit. Just a slight shade, a little bit darker shade, make your pleat look much poppier. So I'm going to click on OK to confirm. So let me zoom in into this 2D window too, so we can compare. Right here, these odd segment that we create, so 3 by 3, and we create this 1.5 pleat. And right here we create 6 segments, and here came out three pleats perfectly. And right here we create seven segments and it came out 3.5 pleats. And right here we create three pleats from the pleats tool. Right here we created from the fold, pleats fold tool. So pleats fold tool with the pleats sewing tool, pleats fold tool with the pleats sewing tool for these three pleats piece that we create. And we did change all the particle distance to 5, and this pattern thickness rendering we changed it to 1.5 to produce this amazing pleat looking thing. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks so much for watching, Designistas. If you find this video useful, remember to sub and click on the bell for more awesome videos. Love it. Thanks, guys.